call you to order the meeting of the Committee on City Services of the Northampton City Council. And note for the record that present are Councilor O'Donnell, Councilor Bidwell, Councilor LaBarge, and myself, Councilor Maureen Carney. Note that there is no public comment this afternoon, and ask if there is a motion to approve the minutes of the December 5th.
Second.
Okay, moved and seconded to approve the December 5th meeting. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed or corrections?
I guess I'll abstain since I wasn't here.
You wish. Okay, all those in favor, did we say aye? Aye.
I said aye.
That carries. And then we have a number of items to be referred, that were referred to this committee, and different folks took the initiative to follow up on these appointments. So I guess we'll just go right down the line, if that's okay. And I have on the Community Preservation Committee, Councilor Bidwell,
yes.
Report on Linda Morley?
Yes, I spoke with Linda last week. I've known Linda for some time. She was the, I think, general counsel in the role at Hamp, the housing organization. She's tremendously experienced in that field, and now that she's retired there, she's very ably fills this sort of affordable housing slot on the CPC. She's very pleased to be reappointed. She's very happy with the workings of that committee and very happy with the projects that they've been bringing to us. So I would certainly recommend a positive recommendation.
Okay. Would the folks like to move these as a group or one by one? Okay, so
either one.
Okay, so why don't we just get the report on each, and then we can decide if we want to send them as a group with a positive recommendation. We can do that. Councilor LaBarge,
Park. Yep. I spoke with Donna by phone, and she has lived in our city for over 50 years. She's a retired school teacher, and she has enjoyed using the senior services in our city. She was told to apply for the position and really feels that it is important to help and be a member of the community, and by serving on the board, she will be able to help our elderly in our city engage in many services offered to them.
Okay. And are you going to recommend for the rest of the body a positive recommendation?
Yes, I would recommend that.
Okay. And I spoke with the next applicant, Mark Nijane, who's an attorney with the firm of Nijane and Kling. And Mr. Nijane is applying for the Council on Aging and has served on numerous committees already, has served on the Planning Board, on the Zoning Board of Appeals, and on the Conservation Commission. So he's got a lot of experience already working on committees for the city. He was especially interested, as he said, he was especially interested in the fact that the Council on Aging meetings are at a time that's a little bit more amenable to him in his practice. And also says he's at a time in his life where he'll be using many of the senior center services, and looks forward to being a user member of the council as well. He also noted that his firm does a lot of work with estate and probate law, and may be helpful to the director or members of the Council on Aging should that be something to consider. So I would, when the time comes, recommend a positive recommendation for Mark Nijane. And the Historical Commission, Barbara Blumenthal, is that Councilor Bidwell?
I spoke with her, yes. Actually, all of these are reappointments, and you may notice that they all expire at the same time. Yeah, that's a bit unusual. I talked to Sarah LaValle, and I guess this dates to when the Elm Street Historic Commission and the Historic Commission were merged, and somehow that resulted in everybody's term starting at the same time. They hope to fix that so that it's staggered at some point. But in the meantime, kind of all up for reappointment at the same time. Barbara has enjoyed her stint on the commission. She brings a perspective, including her involvement with Historic Northampton for a good many years. She considered it to be a really good working commission with a good variety of experience there. She's happy to be reappointed. So I would make a positive recommendation for Barbara Lumenthal.
Okay, and Council LaBarge, you have two folks here?
Yep, we've got Bruce Krabinski. He's a reappointment also to the Historical Commission. Bruce is a registered architect and certified urban planner, and we have emailed each other. He has been able to work with individual historic structures as well as historic neighborhoods, and he has been very active in the field of historic preservation, both professionally and as an advocate since 1960. And he also said, based on his experience, he has come to believe that preserving both the cultural and the natural environment of cities is the best way to encourage and guide sustainable development, particularly here in Northampton. David has been a member of the commission for several years now and would like to continue his service, and I make a recommendation to City Council. David Drake also is a reappointment to the Historical Commission. David has been on the Historical Commission at least 12 years to volunteer membership in the commission, often at the expense of his family activities or other commitments. As chair in his role, he has been to help guide the city's stewardship of its rich heritage. They have done that through management and enlargement of the local historic district on Elm Street and now Round Hill, carefully with the city's demolition delay ordinance. In the near future, and this is what David is saying, they will examine whether the existing local historic district ordinances are sufficient to respond to new challenges the district has faced. David would like to be reappointed back on the commission, and he will continue to provide his highest level of commitment, wisdom, and judgment, and I recommend that.
Okay, thank you. And Martha Lyon.
I spoke with Martha last week. She's currently the vice chair of the commission. Many of us know her as a landscape architect that's been involved in cemetery projects in Bridge Street and Farms, and she's a very experienced landscape architect. She would like to see some means to bring greater attention to cemeteries. She too mentioned that there's talk of revisiting the ordinance, and it's possible the revised ordinance might be working its way to the council at some point regarding the powers of the Historical Commission. But I would and a positive recommendation from our client.
Thank you.
Dylan Gaffney is another reappointment. Mr. Gaffney works at Forbes Library, has lots of experience with historical documents and archiving, this kind of thing. I've known him for a while, he's Ward 3 resident, and I have no doubt that it would be a good idea to reappoint him to this book. The commission is certainly happy to make that recommendation.
And for the Zoning Board of Appeals,
Yep, Bob is a reappointment, and Bob was previously on the planning board for many years, and then he enjoyed serving in the city in that capacity. Now he has been on the zoning board of appeals for about 15 years, most recently as an alternate. I have considerable experience in this capacity, and this is what Bob has stated to me. I have a construction supervisor's license, so I often understand the issues being discussed. I like to support the process of serving people who already live in the community and want to remain in the city. So he would like to be looked at to be reappointed again.
Sarah Northrup is a reappointment. She has, I think, considerable experience on the zoning board of appeals. She's a civil engineer, I think, by profession, and I think she's a very involved community member. I've seen her a number of things in the Bay State Village. So I think she should be reappointed.
Okay, very good. And Councilor Bowling?
Yes. I didn't have a chance to talk to David. He's been on vacation for a while, but I've known him for a long time. He's been on the ZBA for 10 years. I know from his colleagues there he's very highly regarded. He brings 31 years of practice as a real estate attorney. Tremendously well qualified for the role. I would recommend his reappointment.
Do you want to take all of these and then take up Molly Hale?
Yes.
Okay, so I'll ask if folks want to move them.
I would move forward a positive recommendation for all of these, for CPC, Council on Aging, Historical Commission, and ZBA.
Okay, that's a motion. Any
seconded?
All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? None? Carries? Okay, so moving on to the appointment of Molly Hale. I know Molly Hale primarily through her work with the Broadbrook Coalition and the numerous conservation land around the Broadbrook and Fitzgerald Lake that we have acquired over the years and her activity around that. Molly is also very active as a wildlife biologist and naturalist. That's her profession. So an appointment to the tree committee is perfect. She's very active around issues of climate change and is specifically interested in promoting the use of street trees and affecting positive climate effects. So I would recommend a positive recommendation for Molly Hale and ask for that motion. All right, so that brings us to our discussion regarding our committee focus. And I think we decided to forego any presentation today because it would have been the IT department. We know that they're in the midst of doing their reorganization right now. So we did talk about what we might like to do in the upcoming year in terms of departmental presentations. And I guess I'll open it up to folks' ideas about that. Yes.
I would like to have the Department of Public Works come to one of our meetings whenever. I have a lot of residents, which I've already had a meeting with the mayor and so forth with a resident in regards to the amount of money already that has been placed into the stormwater utility fee ordinance. People would like to know, and I'd like to have the Department of Public Works come to talk to us about exactly what have they been doing with the money that has been placed into that fee.
Yes, Counselor.
I actually had a conversation about this very subject with Council President White this morning. And there is a report forthcoming on the use of those funds, as I understand it, and it's mandated that there be such an annual report. He suggested that the opportunity for discussing this would be when that report comes forward, and he was suggesting that that report work its way through the Public Works and Utilities Committee on its way to, well, I don't know if it would be on its way to Council. I don't know if there's such a report needs to be formally accepted by the Council or if it's just submitted for information purposes. But in any event, the suggestion was that we have the kind of discussion we're talking about with that Public Works and Utilities Committee somewhere in the next several months.
Yeah, I was going to say, it seems that since we have a committee that's dedicated to Public Works and Committee, that would be the more appropriate place to bring forward that and that specific discussion about the stormwater.
What committee is that?
We have a subcommittee, City Council Committee on Public Works and Utilities.
Right, right.
Who's on that besides you? You chair that, Councilor, right?
I chair it, and Councilor Murphy, Councilor White, and Councilor Nash. That's the makeup of the committee.
Oh, thank you, Pam. And so by our bylaws, just so that we know, what we have for related departments are Parks and Recreation,
yeah.
Veteran Services, Council on Aging Senior Services, Forbes and Lilly Libraries, Police, Fire Rescue, Health Department, Board of Health, Parking Enforcement, Information Technology, Public Safety Communications, mm-hmm. Emergency Management, and the Building Commissioner.
No DPW?
No, because they have a whole committee
okay.
dedicated almost entirely
okay.
to them.
Well, we'll get that information.
And certainly, whichever of those committee meetings on which that winds up on the agenda, obviously everybody's wanting to attend.
Right, because I do know people have been asking for it and they can't get it.
Yep. So it's, my understanding is that that such a report is in the works and
okay.
can be in position to discuss it in the next couple of months, actually.
Oh, great. Thank you for that info.
Okay, well, given that and given what I just read for our related departments, I'll read again, just if it's helpful, what our charge is from the council rules. The committee may develop, review, and recommend policies on matters including public safety and public health, veterans affairs, social services, libraries, disability, aging, and recreation, among others. The committee shall serve as the standing committee to review all candidates for appointments to boards and commissions in accordance with Section 2-10 of the Charter. And I read the related departments.
Maybe the police department again.
Well, I assume that...
Which one have we not had come in yet?
I think we did.
We did Lilly.
You had the library.
Did public health ever come
No,
in?
I don't think we.
I thought we had
yes,
a
we
presentation
did have public health
really?
With Meredith.
Oh, okay. I guess that's one of the ones.
Yeah.
Parks and Rec didn't come.
Yeah,
that's
what I was thinking. Yeah. Okay.
You know, my own preference and recommendation would be that we not necessarily just go through the rotation for the sake of having folks come, but invite folks on the basis of particular issues that we see there. And,
right.
and certainly, there are issues. It'd be interesting to hear from the Parks Department about how their new headquarters is working out, how from their point of view, Pulaski Park is working out. So there's going to be issues to talk about.
So do you imagine that we would have an issue, for example, that might then bring two or three departments together to give us a report, and we might ask them to among themselves combine and give us something.
I could see that, and to have a few more issue on it than just kind of department by department. I know we had Councilor O'Donnell and I talked a little bit about that, though, you know, in the last go round, and we moved a little bit in that direction this last year, I think.
So do you have an example or something that we might, an issue and the related?
Well, one example would be, and as I said, I wasn't here, so this probably got discussed, but the opioid crisis as it is hitting Northampton, you know, there's police department, there's public health, there's a variety of different jurisdictions that very much public safety are very much involved there, as one example. Or, you know, coming down the pike, depending on what our new national administration brings us, there could be a number of interesting issues involving a number of departments, including police, pertaining to our sanctuary city status and our relationship to the federal government. Maybe that's something larger than here, but that would be an issue that would cut across several departments as well. I don't know, it's just a couple possibilities.
Well, so logistically, if we were to proceed along these lines, if we were to start with, for example, the issue of opioid crisis.
That sounds like the committee meeting that I missed.
It was specifically related to the public health department. I mean, we have had fire and rescue touch on it in terms of, you know, their emergency services.
Yeah. No, I think Councilor Bidwell's point is well taken, that it's an issue that brings in multiple agencies. But that group that we had, Healthy Hampshire, I guess that's a program of the district attorney's office, technically, unless I'm mistaken. But I think it was facilitated by the health department. I think they arranged the meeting.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that said, I mean, you know, it's not like we couldn't revisit it. I mean, I think we had triple the overdoses last year in Northampton than the year before. But I also think it's important, as Council Bidwell points out, we don't want to just rotate people through, you know, and have the same conversations.
Right.
So, I don't know, perhaps would it make sense to ask the Recreation Department to come in first, since it seems like there are questions of them? And maybe at that meeting we could kind of brainstorm ideas and bring issues and topics to that meeting and discuss it again at that time, just a thought.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Very good.
Yeah, that would absolutely make sense.
Right. We want to give departments a little bit of a heads up.
True.
I think if we want to have three departments come in at once, for example,
right.
Which is what we're talking about, right? Probably
two or three, depending on the topic.
Right. If the idea is to have multiple departments, would one have two?
Mm-hmm.
So I think logistically it would be helpful if we were to kind of break some of that. I mean, if now isn't a good time to, we know that, for example, if we were to have a revisit of the opioid issue, we would want the health department, we'd want fire and rescue, and we'd want police.
Like a round table,
right? So that's one. And we were to ask those three departments to come and to focus their remarks around that.
School department and MIS?
A school department also around the opioid?
No.
Oh,
I thought you were going on to another one.
Oh, okay, so we could move on to another one. And what might that be?
But you want the school department also to come in with that, correct?
Well, the school
department, fire rescue.
The school
police.
Department isn't really one of our departments,
yeah.
and so I think having three departments, I think it gets a little weighty if we have more than three.
Well, I think we have enough.
Yeah, so I think three, when we're talking about these joint presentations, we're talking about two or three.
Right. See, I'd like to have the school department at MIS somewhere down the line to come in also and give us an update on how they're doing with the changing.
Yeah, I don't know that the school department would come in, but certainly Antonio Pagan would come from the MIS, from IT.
Definitely.
So, but are there overlapping? So if we're looking at an issue with IT, is there some other department that, or is there some overarching theme or focus that we would like them to discuss beyond just the scope of their? So it's not just a report to us, but rather addressing some wider global issue.
I suppose with information technology, there's an internal use across all the departments, but maybe there's also a public use. I mean, how well are we doing in terms of access to information? You know, even with, I think Councilor Dwight mentioned this at our council meeting last week about tracking where bills are in the process. Actually, that is an idea that I'd like to suggest. You know, if you go onto the Massachusetts legislature's page, you can track bills. Like, oh, it's in this committee, here's the result. It would be interesting to explore at some point. And the IT department has a lot on their plate right now. And I don't want to spend money that. But, you know, it would be interesting, how can we improve our transparency in terms of what we do in the council? Maybe other departments could also take advantage of that. I don't know, the public side of information technology. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so the public side of IT, I'm just making some overarching themes right here. Public side of IT, do we see other departments besides the IT presenting in that?
I don't know about other departments, but one of the other issues that we touched on it when there was a presentation of the whole council, maybe there's really nothing more to be said about it, but it interested me, is how we accommodate the variety of services provided by MIS with transparency, also assuring the confidentiality of sensitive information in so many different departments. I mean, I think it was, we were told that that's a paramount objective, and maybe there's nothing more to be said than that other than a technical explanation that I wouldn't understand. But
would it make sense then with regard to IT that it actually be a dedicated meeting to the IT, to that department with a variety of questions? It seems like there's a few different questions.
Sure.
Okay, so I'm going to set that one to the side because that's not falling under the notion of global themes with multiple departments, but rather one. So we'll try to identify a time, a good meeting month in the next, in 2017. Maybe even soon, could give us more time to generate some ideas. But it would be helpful if we had a couple of areas that we know that we could actually, even at this meeting, set a date for this themed meeting to deal with the opioid crisis in three different departments. And we could set that ahead enough in time that we could be in touch with those three departments. March. What do you think?
You
don't have any.
Oh, I defer to the chair on that. I mean,
okay. Well, I'm just so that could take care of one. And then, were there some other themes besides the opioid crisis that might overlap among various departments, so that we don't get in, you know? Yep.
One is public art. You know, I think when you talk about public art, we often think it's the jurisdiction of just one department, the art and culture department.
Which
actually,
isn't one of our departments, but
right.
What is it called? What's the
planning and sustainability?
The department version of the Arts Council.
We used to have a city council subcommittee on arts and recreation. We don't have
arts
that
and
anymore.
Culture arts or community resources.
Okay.
It's community resources.
Okay. Well, it falls under community resources. I guess the point I was making is that really public art kind of there should be kind of, that should be part of the mission of almost every department, certainly planning.
Are there some under our listed number of departments that you'd call in on that subject?
Oh, I don't know.
And that, I'll read them again. Parks and Rec, Parks and Rec would be one, right?
That's true, maybe it's a little outside of this.
Well, Parks and Rec, libraries, the libraries would have to do with that. The Parks and Rec, libraries, and certainly, information technology? I would say Parks and Recs, oh, seniors, council on aging, I don't know, I mean, there's that.
I think Parks and Rec and council on aging would go together.
Okay.
So what, so is, does arts, so arts falls under community resources?
Yes, yeah. But let's, it doesn't preclude our dealing with the issue of public art. It just,
What does it say, arts?
We could, we could.
It doesn't, it says it for community resources.
But we could address it in part when, you know, when Parks Department comes in.
Right.
You're talking about Pulaski.
Right.
And public art, that would be one way.
Yeah, or maybe the idea is not fully formed enough to stand on its own, so it should be part of the Recreation Department, yeah. I don't know, I'm just kind of.
I mean, would it make sense to bring in the libraries with the Rec Department to talk about public art?
I guess I would need more preparation personally before I can make a recommendation on that.
Okay.
Okay. Well, maybe the opioid one doesn't need more thought.
No, I think we.
Some of the other ones might require some more thought. We're gonna call multiple departments. I don't have really good questions for them.
Right, right.
So we're asking a lot for them to come in. So that's just me, I wouldn't be able to give a full answer right now on the art thing.
Yeah, okay. But that's a, okay, that's a possibility.
Yep.
I'm just trying to think, you know, logistically of how we're gonna do this over the next 12 months.
Right.
We actually have, two meetings with, if we know that we wanna talk to, IT, we would have a dedicated meeting with them to, because we have a number of issues that we'd like to talk about with them. The opioid crisis, that would be one other month, and that would take care, that would focus on three issues, I mean, three departments, Health Department, Fire Rescue, and Police. Mm-hmm. So we have another 10 months, 10 meetings.
Someone had also mentioned Sanctuary City says.
Yeah.
That would be a separate topic then, right?
So, yeah, I
and there would, so it would mean bringing in the committee, I mean, the department might come in multiple times on different topics.
That's true, I mean, I think it's also possible that if we want to ask folks to come and talk to us on the basis of emerging issues, that we don't have to have all 12 months. So, you know, we've got 3 months in advance now.
Yeah.
And it may be, based on how things go, that we would want to address the issue of sanctuary cities down the road, but I'm not sure we know enough about it at this point. So I, going back to Councilor Donald's recommendation, maybe, you know, if we have parks for a meeting, opioid crisis for a meeting, ITMIS for a meeting, there's three meetings worth, and then maybe we can all be thinking about others down the road. And maybe we just devote a little bit of every meeting to sort of you know, being, you know, what, 3 months down the road.
Right.
Also, too, I would like you to consider the Committee of Veteran Services also.
Do you think we'd like to bring in the Veteran Services Committee when we're talking about the opioid crisis, or is that, I mean,
I don't know enough about it to know.
They have a lot of functions coming up, a lot of parades coming up and so forth, and usually when they come in, they present exactly what is going on for the year.
So you'd like to see just a meeting with the Veteran Services Committee?
Yeah, if we could.
Because
the usually
Services
they have the...
Department.
Yeah. Steve Connors and... at VFW, they're all involved. The Veterans Council.
What we could do is we could take the next 3 months with dedicated departmental presentations with Parks and Rec, Information Technology, and Veteran Services. And in the meantime, and then the fourth month ahead, we could plan on this overarching topic of the opioid crisis and ask health, fire, and rescue, and police. It means we won't get a full report from, I mean, what we've typically gotten from those departments, police, fire, and rescue. They typically come in with their, you know, agenda for, you know, what's going on, and they have their stats and their data usually to show us. But if we're kind of moving away from that and asking them to focus their presentation on that, we might want to leave it open for them to. We are actually the committee that, or it used to be, as the Public Safety Committee, and I think that that's still our charge. When there were some particular things from the fire department, purchases and things like that, they used to have to come through this committee. But I haven't seen that in a while. Does that ring a bell, Pam? No? I mean, I thought we had to deal with stuff with their engine, but that might have been, it was back
through finance now.
Okay.
One thing in general is with our budget process, I don't know, I've often thought we might want to re-examine how we run the budget process. And we have these big two-day hearings, and we try and cram all these departments in. Mm-hmm. I don't know if it would ever make sense at some point to have those hearings be more focused on the finance department and Susan Wright. But if we want to have meetings in our committees about certain departments, they could happen in committee perhaps. Might be a way to have a more focused conversation. But that's more of a conceptual remark. I don't know that it's an easy one to just write down and plan on.
And I also think like having the budget hearings just for 2 days is really cramming it. Mm-hmm. And way back, they used to sometimes 3 to 4 days.
Wow. I guess I would say I kind of agree that we have maybe a couple of them lined up now, and mm-hmm. we could make further determinations later.
Okay.
Well, I'm certainly fine with your recommendation that the next three be parks, where we can, you know, in advance tell them there's some particular issues we're interested in, and IT, and Veteran Services. Those could be the next three. And then roughly formed in April, say, with the opioid crisis, but we've got a little time to further shape it and then think about what the more thematic meetings in May and June might be also.
Mm-hmm. And just so folks know, I just counted up, there's 13 related departments, but that doesn't assume that we'll see all. I mean, last year we missed Parks and Rec, but we saw it all. And did we see the veterans the first time? So.
And the person to get in charge is Brad LeVay. I talk with him all the time. He's the president of the Veterans Council, who works very closely with Steve Connors.
Okay, so it sounds like, and you said that there are some specific questions for Parks and Rec?
Well, we talked about Pulaski Park, the public art matter, which I agree is worthy of discussion. You know, I guess I'll be a little bit interested in how their new location is working out.
Get those, Pam?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay, so that's Parks and Rec maybe for February? Okay.
Sounds good.
And we still want to meet with the IT department and Veteran Services?
Yeah.
So do you want to Veteran Services maybe in March?
Sure.
That sounds fine because I think their parade starting in what, May.
You may want to talk to Brad LeVay.
Flag Day coming up.
You know him.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Yeah, you talk to him.
one in March. What did you say, March?
I think March for vet services. It's February, March, and then that would bring us to April for the IT department, and maybe May for a more themed presentation or update on the opioid crisis.
Yeah.
That's a good plan.
With Brad LeBay, would you like me to ask him to bring in specifically the schedule of what they have? Because they always do that.
Well,
and they do talk about their money, because they do get money from, that is given by the mayor to them so much a year and so forth. Can they break that down also?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But Pam will have to be in touch with Steve Horn.
Yep.
Yeah.
No, for the mayor.
Yeah.
Right. Through the mayor.
Office.
Yeah. The office.
And sometimes Steve comes, sometimes he does not, depending on his schedule. So Veterans handles it because Brad is the president and the vice president comes in them.
Yep.
But she's gonna
his
work
secretary
it out with the
Norbert used to come and take his place.
Right.
And he's gone.
Right. Okay, and then we're leaving as tentative still from a health department, fire and rescue and police.
Mm-hmm.
To be refined a little bit.
Right. Okay. Is there any new business? Okay, is there a motion?
I would move to adjourn.
Sorry.
Yeah. All right, all those in favor, aye.
Aye.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
All right, thank you.